Welcome to our second video in our SOLIDWORKS What's New for 2025 series. My name is Ed Hawkins, and over the next few minutes I will take you through some improvements in sheet metal and weldments. We need to finalise some details of this part before submitting to our team for review. First, we're going to edit our cut list. Let's take a look at this sheet metal part. We want to add a new cut list item called Process, and in this case, the sheet metal items would be cut on a water jet. In SOLIDWORKS 2025, you can now copy this one cut list property to all cut list items. The old method of manually creating these properties would have taken a considerable amount of time. However, some of these are not going to be cut on the water jet. They'll need to be cut on the bandsaw. We can simply change the property once and copy it to the specified items. Confirming that we want to override the existing data, we can see that those items have been copied properly. Let's zoom in on this sheet metal part and flatten it. It's tough to highlight, but behind the scenes, SOLIDWORKS 2025 has improved fold, unfold and flatten performance for parts with a large amount of sheet metal bodies or many cuts within bends. SOLIDWORKS 2025 introduces a new command called bend notch. Bend notches are going to allow you to streamline your downstream manufacturing processes by adding physical marks on your sheet metal bodies. This makes it easy for the operator to line up those marks in the press brake. Several options are available: triangular, circular, and rectangular. And of course, the ability to adjust the sizes as needed. Tab and slot workflows have also been improved. There is now an option for equal offset when we're using equal spacing. This allows you to offset the pattern from the extents of your selected edge. The right-hand side of this part should be different to make orientation obvious. New in SOLIDWORKS 2025 is the center align option, which places the tab symmetrically along the selected edge. 2025 also introduces the ability to skip instances for tab and slot. Let's flatten that again so we can see the results. The final operation for the sheet metal body is to add edge flanges to close it off. In previous versions of SOLIDWORKS, creating edge flanges of equal length was possible in the same operation, but if you wanted different lengths, you'd have to edit the edge flange profile and dimension the sketch. SOLIDWORKS 2025 streamlines this workflow. Simply check multi-length flange and adjust the lengths as necessary. I'll change the default radius here to something more appropriate. SOLIDWORKS 2025 also gives you the option to automatically fully define the lengths of the edge flange sketch, saving time, especially for teams that have a directive to fully define all sketches. Our part has several welds in place, but there is one area we haven't completed. We want to create a weld that fills this gap between the chamfered edge and plate. SOLIDWORKS 2025 introduces groove bead to accurately represent these weld types. We can even define a weld symbol on the fly. A single weld is not sufficient, so let's use mirror. Since these are bodies, they are extremely easy to mirror. Back in SOLIDWORKS 2022, we saw the introduction of the option to use multiple planes or faces when mirroring, as well as the handy Q key shortcut to expose reference geometry for easy selection. We'll utilize those options for mirroring this weld. SOLIDWORKS 2025 can help you save time by quickly copying cut list properties to many items. It helps you streamline your downstream manufacturing processes with bend notches, gives you greater flexibility in your tab and slot workflows, and allows you to use multiple length edge flanges without having to edit the flange profile. You can now create a new type of weld bead in SOLIDWORKS 2025 called groove beads between two solid bodies. And sheet metal performance has dramatically improved for parts with large amounts of items, and so have the cut list updates. For complex weldment profiles, we now have the ability to allow protrusions during planar body trim. And there are also several enhancements to the structure system. We've seen improved creation of structure system, as well as an improved corner treatment user interface. We can mirror a pattern structure system or pattern a mirror structure system. And you can also trim members with connection elements as shown here. Thanks very much for watching, and look out for our next video on what's new for assemblies in SOLIDWORKS 2025.